So Betsy Brown, this is Jim Cameron.
Nice to meet you.
James Cameron is now just waiting on the weather to make his descent into the deepest part of the ocean. The Canadian filmmaker and National Geographic explorer plans to dive the Challenger Deep in the Marianas Trench after the seas calm. Cameron has been interested in the ocean since he was a child.
Seems like my whole life. You know, since I was a kid, I've been fascinated by the deep ocean. And I wrote a story in high school called The Abyss that was about people diving deeper and deeper.
He started planning the real dive to the depths about 7 years ago.
We got the idea in 2002 when we were out at Bismarck. And that's the deepest I dived to that date, which was 16,000 feet. And we started thinking, myself and Ron Allum, the co-designer of the sub, well, what kind of vehicle, what would it look like? If we really thought outside the box, how would we solve the problem now with the engineering that we know and maybe engineering that we'd have to investigate to get to the full ocean depth of 36,000 feet?
That vehicle is the Deep Sea Challenger. And PNC got to take a look at the submarine while on board the Mermaid Sapphire with Cameron this morning. The Deep Sea Challenger is made almost entirely of foam. But it's a special kind of foam designed by Cameron and his team to withstand the extreme pressure he'll find at the bottom of the ocean, which will take his sub less than 2 hours to reach.
It's got two fins. They're actually on the back. And if you imagine, it's kind of like a Swiss Army knife. When it's descending, one fin folds up and the other one acts as a stabilizer when it's going down. When it's coming up, the reverse happens. The top one folds down and the bottom fin stabilizes the sub. Because this sub screams down and screams back to the surface.
Cameron is confident that the buoyancy control available on the Deep Sea Challenger will give him the ability to get the images that he wants.
I was able to operate in the finest, like cigarette ash fine silt at the bottom of the New Britain Trench. I expect to find the same thing in the Challenger Deep and in the Sirena Deep.
And since this is a scientific exploration, the sub also has the ability to collect samples from the sea floor.
We designed this vehicle as a science platform, so it has a payload bay that we can put different sampling equipment in. I'll make the first dive to full ocean depth with what we call a slurp gun sample. It's a suction sample, kind of like a vacuum cleaner, essentially. And there's a hose that runs down the manipulator arm. There's a manipulator that I can pick up rock samples. I can pick up biological specimens and put them into that suction sampler. There's a hydraulically actuated core sampler that runs down the side of the vehicle. We're just mounting that now.
While the Deep Sea Challenger measures nearly 25 feet in length, Cameron, who is 6 feet 2 inches tall himself, will be crammed into a space only 43 inches wide to pilot the sub. And he'll be busy at work during the estimated 6 hours he'll spend exploring the ocean floor.
The pilot is very busy in this vehicle. I've got 7 joysticks, and I've got to take one hand off one to work another one in order to operate the lights. There are lights that are on pan and tilt, spotlights that move, cameras that move, manipulators that move, thrusters that have to be continuously operated. I asked them for some software to control the thrusters so it would help keep me in place while I'm moving some of the other things. But, you know, you're pretty busy.
The Deep Sea Challenge is sponsored by National Geographic and Rolex. You can learn more about the expedition online at deepseachallenge.com. Betsy Brown, PNC News.